Hi, I'm Matthias and this is Hattie, and welcome to StudyTime's Level 2 Waves exam strategy video.
Cool, in this standard you'll be focusing on wave behaviour as well as concepts such as reflection, refraction and diffraction. For wave behaviour, you'll want to understand the different types of waves as well as how velocity, frequency and wavelength interrelate. When it comes to those other concepts, we're talking about diffraction, so light moving between slits. You'll be talking about refraction, which is light moving between different media. And you'll be talking about reflection, both for light or for pulses through strings. Focusing on light waves, you'll also be looking at the different types of mirrors and lenses. It's a really big part of the standard, so it's really important that you understand how these different mirrors and lenses behave.
There are three main types of questions. There's drawing diagrams, word, written explanations, and then also calculations. A really big part of this standard is understanding how waves behave. So drawing a diagram to justify your answers is also a really good idea. If you follow all of these tips, you're going to come out on top.
First, we'll be looking at mirrors and lenses. The most common mistake that probably crops up on these questions is using the wrong type of mirror or lens, so using concave instead of convex. To make sure you're not one of the people who makes this mistake, you should practice drawing lots of diagrams. You should also practice incorporating explanations into your questions, such as the properties of the image, so whether it's virtual, magnified, upright, as well as whether it's a converging or a diverging lens.
That's a lot of information, so let's break it down. Mirrors have two types, concave and convex. Lenses have two types, concave and convex. In all of these situations, the light rays will either converge or diverge. Get very comfortable with what these words mean and familiarize yourself with what they look like on ray diagrams. You will be expected to draw ray diagrams, so make sure you practice a lot of these for a lot of different situations. There's only three principal rays that you need to draw, and they help you figure out what kind of image you'll get. Then you need to describe the image. Is it upright or inverted, diminished or enlarged, virtual or real?
Now let's talk about critical angles. So what is a critical angle? Well, think back to refraction. Refraction happens when light is moving from one medium to another and it bends either towards or away from the normal. Side note, make sure you know how to rearrange Snell's law to solve these kinds of refraction questions. Total internal reflection is when the light doesn't just refract between the two media, instead it's reflected inside the first medium. And right before this happens, we have what's called the critical angle, which is the angle where the light will be moving from the first medium and then will be refracted right along between the boundary between the two media. This only happens when the light is moving from a more dense medium to a less dense medium. Now, hopefully this is all information that you already know. The trick is remembering all of it and putting it together. So for example, let's say that the question said, the critical angle between glass and air is 47 degrees. What is the refractive index of glass? Then you just want to plug that into Snell's law, rearrange, and you'd be all set. You'd want to take into account that the angle of incidence is 47 degrees, and because it's the critical angle, the angle of refraction must be 90 degrees.
Answering these questions requires a little bit of logic and a little bit of problem solving. You'll also need to fully break down the question in order to get full marks. A really common question is, what are the requirements for total internal reflection? Well, firstly, how does it get refracted so far? Well, it must be refracted by greater than 90 degrees, meaning it comes back inside. It is reflected. Another requirement is that the medium that the light ray is entering must be less optically dense. Think of a few scenarios where this applies, such as the light ray is traveling from water to air or from glass to air. If you break down the question fully, you're going to get full marks.
The final thing we really want to stress is path difference and interference. This will come up and you will need to draw a diagram. And these diagrams are kind of weirdly hard, so you'll really want to practice. In the exam, look for questions that are about, say, two speakers or two gaps in rocks that water waves are going through. So the idea is that path difference is how much further one wave has traveled than the other to get to that spot. And this leads to interference, either constructive interference, where the two waves are building on top of each other and making a bigger wave, or destructive interference, where they're cancelling each other out and you get no movement at all. If you learn to recognize these questions and get good at those diagrams, you'll be set to get some good marks.
All right, so to summarize, when giving an explanation, writing it down, you should use a diagram to aid your answer. It really helps to figure out what's going on. Also, there are way fewer equations in the standard than in the other standards, so you can practice and familiarize yourself with them a lot more easily. There's two equations given for each, figuring out the distance and height of the image and the magnification of the image. You only need to use one of them, so get familiar with the one that makes the most sense to you. Also, you should try and break the questions down and structure your answers nicely. Often you'll be given bullet points to follow closely, and that'll tell you exactly what you need to include in your answer.
We've tried to cover some helpful tips, but we haven't been able to cover everything. So we really recommend checking out the past few years of exams, also checking out the study time guides, which are available free online or to purchase in print. And they're set up to help you ace your exam. So good luck.